Hello, I'm Dr. Singh, the CEO of Access Healthcare Physicians LLC, and I'm here to talk about something extremely important with our Chief Nursing Officer, Ms. Cindy Heitzman. And I want to talk about elder abuse and any kind of concerns we have about any patient being either neglected or abused by a loved one, a friend, or anyone else they know of. So, Cindy, please tell us about the laws in the state about abuse and neglect.
I'd be happy to, Dr. Singh. Florida law is very, very specific on the different types of abuse and the reporting requirements for healthcare providers. If you're a licensed healthcare provider in the state of Florida, you are bound under Florida statute or Chapter 39 and Chapter 415 of the Florida statutes to report any suspected abuse or neglect. There are many types of abuse and neglect, as you know. In 2016, the Florida Department of Elder Affairs was able to confirm 2,564 cases of elder abuse being reported by healthcare providers throughout the state. That equates to 7 a day, and it is increasing as time goes on. So it's very, very important that all of our healthcare providers understand their role in identifying and reporting suspected abuse.
And the reason it's important is we have so many elderly patients who are depending on us. And we are not just providers who are hands-off. We are the keepers of our patients. We are their advocates. We
Absolutely.
are their friends, and we want them to be safe. So patient care is not just about writing a prescription
No.
or ordering a test, but also doing what is right. And keeping the safety of our patients in mind.
Absolutely.
But sometimes, suppose I have a confusion whether it's really abuse or not. Suppose I just have a suspicion. What is the right thing to do in that circumstance?
If you have a suspicion and you feel like there's something going on, but you can't quite put your finger on it, give either myself or our case management department a call.
Right.
We're the safety net for our physicians, our healthcare providers, when it comes to reporting abuse and neglect. And what I do want to make sure that everyone is aware of is that there's immunity built into the law.
Right.
So if you suspect abuse and neglect and you report it and it is found that there's no problem in the home or there's no exploitation of that vulnerable adult, your name is not disclosed. So there is protection in the law for our healthcare providers.
And the other thing is, if you do not report it, there are penalties.
There is mandatory reporting requirements for all licensed healthcare personnel. And if you are suspect of abuse and you fail to report it and it is disclosed that you had knowledge, civil penalties can be levied against you.
So, bottom line, you suspect abuse, you
Report it.
report it.
Report it. A progress note is not enough.
Right.
You've got to report.
Just thinking about it or mulling it over or discussing is not going to resolve it. Just make sure you pick up that phone and call the hotline.
Absolutely. It's policy 7.10 in our manual for abuse and neglect. And again, if there's ever any question, the risk management department is here to assist you.
Thank you, Cindy.
You're welcome.